for all of us. And by the way, he loves us with an everlasting love. Amen?
Amen.
God is not looking to get us out of the camp. He wants to get us in.
Amen.
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 He's not looking out to condemn us. We are born condemned.
Amen.
And separated from God. He wants to get us in the palace.
Amen.
We don't need to be a slave to sin or the devil. We don't belong in the boonies. We belong in a palace.
Praise the Lord.
We are children of the King. The Levite wished that he had not passed by at that time on that day. He wished that he had taken a different route. So many times, you see, what I'm trying to say, God does not need our permission to throw problems on us. As a matter of fact, becoming a Christian sometimes is an inconvenience. Serving the Lord is not a bed of roses. We got to develop a hard chair. Amen? Paul says we got to wrestle, we got to fight, we got to struggle. Amen?
Amen.
And verse 33 says, but a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him. Now the man was stripped of his clothing, he was beaten to a pulp, you could not recognize whether he was a Jew or he was a Samaritan or who he was. That was beside the point. There was an individual who was in dire need. Amen? He was a child of God. Now remember, Jesus is answering the question of the lawyer.
Yes.
Who is my neighbor? Mm. Amen?
Yes.
Should I love those only within the context of Judaism? And whom shall I love within the context? Mm. Now Jesus is telling him, who is his neighbor? Listen. So that this Samaritan went to him and bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and set him on his own beast and brought him to the inn and took care of him. Now before the Samaritan took this individual to the inn, first he took care of him, himself.
Yes.
Before Jesus lays any burden on you and I, before Jesus lays any problem on you and I, he takes care of it himself first. Mm. And if you allow problems to come our way, then it's your size.
Oh. Amen, brother.
Amen?
Amen.
Some of us say, Lord, it's too much. You don't know what I'm going through. It's your size. Mm. Jesus takes care of it first. Everything that comes our way passed through the hands of God.
Amen.
I know you read Christ's Object Lessons. I know you read the scriptures. I know you read the Desire of Ages. The Good Samaritan represents Jesus. Mm. And then we'll see who the innkeeper represents. And that's the body of my message. The innkeeper. Amen.
Amen.
We seldom hear about him. So he took off his robe. Is there a correlation here?
Yes.
He took off his robe and placed it on this man who was beaten and bruised and half dead. Amen?
Amen.
His oil, his wine, Isaiah says, by his what?
Yes.
By his stripes we are healed.
Yes.
Whose righteousness?
Right.
My righteousness?
No.
Jesus'
righteousness. His righteousness, amen?
Amen.
Set him on his own beast. And brought him to an inn and took care of him. No. Before we go any further, I want you to turn with me to the book of Exodus, chapter 23, verses 4 and 5. That means the way out, the Exodus. Exodus, chapter 23, verses 4 and 5. If thou meet thy enemy's ox or his ass going astray, thou shalt surely bring it back to him. If thou see the ass of him that hated thee lying under his burden, and willest forbear to help him, thou shalt surely help him. The dumbest of the beasts, the most stupid creatures, God is saying, the owner for the ass, for the donkey, doesn't really care about the animal. All he's concerned about what he can get from the animal. To be a burden bearer. As long as the donkey is an asset to him, he'll make use of it. But once it becomes a liability, he gets rid of it. He's not concerned about it. But there's a scripture that says, if he is your enemy, and you see that the donkey is under a burden, he's being drawn up. God is saying to you, help the beast. Even the neighbor is your enemy. Even the dumb beast, help him. If you see the beast going astray, bring him back to your neighbor who is your enemy. No. The individual who fell victim was not a beast. He was a brother.
Amen.
Amen. But God says, show compassion even to the burden bearer, even to the most stupid creature. Show kindness. Relieve the burden. Be of some assistance. Amen.
Amen.
Be kind to your neighbor. If the beast is going astray, bring it back. But more so to a brother. Amen. I can give you many passages about this story. So, the Samaritan took off his medicine cabinet, bound up his wounds, used his own robe, his own bandage, and he put him in his own SUV. Decided to bring him to the inn. His own SUV. I did not say what kind it was. Might be a BMW. Might be a Lexus. Might be a Benz. But he put him on his own transport and brought him to the inn. While traveling to the inn, he was very careful. He took his time. So that he would not cause further injury to the victim. Not so much caring about his own safety because there was a greater need than his. This man is about to die. I'm going to do so much, but I'm going to take him where he's more comfortable. Amen? So he decided to take him to the inn. Now, verse 35, and on the morrow, which means, when he took him to the inn, he spent all night with him, observing him. Amen?
Amen.
Taking care of him until some kind of, he was revived to some extent. So he took care of him from the very inception when he saw him. Amen? All night he watched him. And in the morning, the Bible says he took out 2 pence and gave them to the host and said unto him, take care of him, and whatsoever thou spendest more, when I come again, I will repay. Now, the scripture does not say whether the innkeeper had any prior engagement or relationship with the Samaritan. Maybe he knew him, Maybe not. When he went to the inn, he inquired for a room. Maybe all the rooms were filled. And no. This innkeeper was a shrewd businessman. He was very good at bookkeeping. He had his fine draperies. He had white linen. The rooms were well kept. He had his maid cleaning the rooms. He had his receptionist at the desk. And he ran a business. His wife had the kids in school. The last thing he needed was a problem on his hands. Things are going good. Have you noticed that when things are going good, when the bills are being paid, when you can have some sense of relaxation, you don't need somebody bringing a problem and dropping it on your lap. That's the last thing you need. Nobody wants extra problem in their lives. And that's the time when Jesus decides to drop something on you. When things are going good. And maybe all the rooms were taken, and the only room he probably had left was the expensive one, that's the suite.
Oh, no.
Because those don't last, because it's expensive. But he got the room anyway. Amen? Now imagine how he felt looking at this individual. Someone is still a bit bloody. He doesn't know the individual. The one who was the victim was beaten and bruised and basically died. But because of the innkeeper, he decided to give him the room. Amen?
Amen.
Now, Jesus did not speak to the priest. The Samaritan did not receive any instructions. The Levite didn't receive any instructions, but the innkeeper was spoken to. Amen? The Samaritan represents Jesus, and Jesus only spoke to the innkeeper. Now the innkeeper represents the church. Amen? The innkeeper represents you and I. He could have left enough money. Maybe the Samaritan was well off. Maybe he could have left a credit card with the innkeeper. But he paid for that night. Amen. And he took out 2 pence. Knowing that it may not cover all the expense. Amen. And then he said to the innkeeper, whatever you spend more, when I come again, he did not say when he's coming again. He did not promise when. When is when? Is the question. Somebody asks you to do a favor. How long, we ask the question, how long do you want me to take care of this problem? How long do you want me to take care of Aunt Mary? How long do you want me to take care of my in-laws? Or this stranger? Or a friend? Or some guy? Or someone? How long is the question? And I believe that's a reasonable question. Amen? He didn't tell him how long. Amen?
Amen.
He said, take care of him. When I come, I will. So he expected, the Samaritan expected the innkeeper to spend his own money.
Yes.
You got it? Somebody's listening to the message. When Jesus died on the cross, he redeemed the entire planet.
Amen.
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 All that we claim that we have, and when I say you, I'm including myself. I'm speaking in the form of the third person. Amen? So I'm not talking about anybody. Amen?
Amen.
to spend what he has given to us. Amen. No, the innkeeper, he's a businessman. He's a shrewd businessman. He's taking notes. Bandage, dressing, new sheet. He's writing on the figures. Amen. He can't take care of the guy himself, but he gotta hire a maid. Somebody to bathe him. Somebody to dress the wounds. Amen. So he gotta calculate that's expense. Amen. So at the end of the day, he's looking at the list. And the day goes by, a week goes by, 2 weeks goes by, and now he stopped taking record. You remember, I'm talking about the old folks. Remember when they just came into this church and they had these cards, the yellow cards and the white cards, and you had a summer school class, and they would ask you how many pieces of literature you gave out, and how many people you helped, and how many money you. I hate it.
Yeah.
I hated that stuff.
Okay.
Because everybody lied.
Everybody lied.
Because you don't want a Sabbath school teacher to be teaching and going on the list and you have nothing to say.
Oh.
So you try to do something during the week just to say you did something. You see, God doesn't want us to keep records. If Jesus had to keep records of all the sins he has forgiven us. But sometimes we keep records of what we have done for him. God doesn't want us to keep records. He expects of us. Whatever he lays on our laps, he expects us to do what he did. No less. Amen. My messenger is entitled the innkeeper, which represents the church. We don't need to take records. Amen.
Amen.
God loves us. Take care of him. Whatever thou spendest for, I will repay. Whatever discomfort, whatever inconvenience, whatever heartache you go through, Jesus is saying, I will repay. And he has promised in this life, in the here and now, 100-fold. And in the life to come, eternal life. We never lose out with Jesus. As a matter of fact, he seeks our interest, amen. He loves every single one of us. So whatever comes our way from the time, it's your size. Amen. God doesn't have to invent special trials just for you because you are not that important. You are not that special. Amen.
Amen.
We are nothing. We have nothing. And we give nothing. On the other hand, he is everything. He has everything, and he gives everything. Amen?
Amen.
When he allows problems to come our way, it is so that we can be strengthened. The devil's intent is that we fall, but God sees something in us that needs to be improved. Now he asks the question to the lawyer. Now listen. His answer was very classic. Now the question was, who then is neighbor to this man? And the lawyer would not even call the name Samaritan. Still in his prejudice, even though he was convicted, he knew the law, but he did not practice the law. He could not bring himself say, well, it was a Samaritan. He said, I suppose the one who showed kindness.
I suppose.
Well, I suppose it's the one who showed kindness. He could not. Can you imagine the prejudice?
Mm.
We are not to love only those within our circle. long as there is a need. We can call ourselves whatever we want. If there's a need and we refuse to help a brother or a sister, a child of God, we are everything but not Christians. That's why Gandhi said, who read the Sermon on the Mount every single day, give me your Christ, but keep your Christians. If Christians would live like the Christ of the Bible, all India would become Christians. So don't stop giving up the food baskets. Don't stop visiting the sick. Now, don't stop going and collecting the food. Don't stop giving Bible studies. Occupy till I come. Take care of the needy. There'll be people coming into our church who we consider as pimps and prostitutes, gray hair, tongue pierced, tattooed all over. They are children of the King.
Amen.
And Jesus said they will go into the kingdom before some of you. Let us not judge anybody because we were all once there.
Amen.
Had it not been for the grace and the mercy of the Almighty God, who loves us and saves us. We belong to Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Our God is truly a loving Heavenly Father. Amen.
Amen.
He loves every single one of us with an everlasting love. Amen.
Amen.
I want you to know, friend of mine, you are special. You're important. You know why I say that the Samaritan represents Jesus? Turn up to Philippians chapter 2. Reading from verse 5, Paul says, Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God. Now, Paul says that Jesus took 7 steps when he humbled himself. Amen? We're going to look at the 7 steps. Reading from verse 5, Paul says, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who made himself of no reputation, he was fully God and he was fully man at the same time. Amen?
Amen.
But as was said in the Sabbath school lesson study, he did not use divinity, amen, as an advantage over you and I. But in the flesh he lived a perfect life, yet without sin. Step number 2, he took upon him the form of a servant. Step number 3, was made in the likeness of men. Step number 4, being found in fashion as a man. Step number 5, he humbled himself. Step number 6, he became obedient unto death, and Paul reiterates what he says. Even the death on the cross. You see, the victims on the cross were crucified butt naked. The artist paints a picture that the victim was properly draped. But Jesus was crucified naked, despising the ultimate shame and humiliation. So he said to us, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Some of us think too highly of ourselves. Some of us say that we have been in the way for X amount of years, and we think that somebody owes us something. And we are third and fourth generation Adventists, you know? And you are a newcomer. But we forget whether we come in early in the morning, at the 3rd hour, at the 6th hour, at the 9th hour, or even 1 hour before the whistle blows, we all get the same reward.
Yes.
Yeah. Amen. And there is work for every one of us to do. Let no one say there is nothing I can do. Amen. There's something for every single one of us. And what a privilege. What a joy it is. So fear thou not, Jesus says, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. Amen. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. He never asks us to do something that which we cannot do. He always provides the means to get it done. He does not call a qualified, but he qualifies those whom he calls.
Amen.
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 All of us are important. All of us are special. All of us are unique in the sight of the Almighty God. We belong to Jesus. Amen. There might be somebody here. You want to make a commitment today. Now, this appeal may not be for you. If you don't stand, it doesn't mean that you're a bad person. This appeal is for those who recognize that I belong to the family of God and He expects of me to do as He did. And as the day approaches, we will have to do even more for the cause of God. Inasmuch as he did it unto one of the least of these, my brethren. You see, the church is not about programs, even though I love programs. The church is about people.
Amen.
Amen. The church is about people. And that should be our goal, that should be our focus, our number, our priority. The salvation of souls. If that is not our business, then we are wasting time. And I say that, friend of mine, without any apology. Amen?
Amen.
As I stand on the sure word of God. Amen? Mm-hmm. God loves us. So after the singing of the closing hymn, I'm going to make the appeal. If you want God to use you, and I stand, including myself, you want God to use us. It's a commitment between you and Jesus. Amen. Ray, could you come and lead us in the song? Our closing hymn is hymn number 213.